Heyo guys, your favorite Kage, Enigma Kage, bringing you yet another video. In this video, I'll be discussing the 5 most requested characters via social media, why I think they are important, and why I feel as though only half of them are going to get into Jump Force Season 2. Next. If you're new to the channel, welcome. I'm Enigma. I'm an anime gaming content creator amongst many things. Stick around and subscribe today. So, as most of you've seen, Season 2 is generating a lot of buzz on both Twitter and on YouTube. So many people have speculated the roster, and some are a bit more accurate than others. Trust me, I would love for Spike Chunsoft and Bandai to transfer over all the licensing from J-Star's Victory Versus over to Jump Force, but we have to be realistic in this approach. So here are the 5 most requested characters via social media. Starting off at number 5, Hiei. Hiei is uber popular amongst old school fans like myself and fans of the Weekly Shonen Jump in general. I have an entire video dedicated to Hiei and why I feel he's coming in the near future. Please check out that video for a more in-depth overview. What I will say is you cannot scroll down Bandai's comment section without seeing Hiei's name pop up. I wouldn't even go as far as saying he's in the top 3 most requested characters. Creeping in at number 4, Yuno. Yuno is the main rival of Asta in Black Clover. Having a season 2 without Yuno is almost a crime in my opinion. What I do think will happen is we will get Yuno and he'll play similar to Galena, which isn't a bad thing, but he'll be one of those long range characters that would take some time getting used to. Yuno's popularity has risen since the last time DLC was announced. I'm sure the reincarnation arc has a whole lot to do with it. Seeing Yuno included with his elf form would be breathtaking for sure. Before I get to the top 3, I'm going to let you know that this lineup is drastically different from what it was 3 to 5 months ago. The original top 3 were Hiei, Suna, and Madaka. Let's just see if that carried on. Rolling in at number 3, Suna. Suna is still a fan favorite from the series Hitman Reborn. A lot of people will argue that
no one is checking for him,
but you're obviously fooling yourself. Suna not being in the main roster really crushed a lot of longtime fans, and seeing him on the Unreal Engine will be breathtaking. I personally do not think we'll get any new series added, but if we do, it'll make sense to add him and my number 2 character on this list. At number 2, we have Tanjiro. Tanjiro is the main character from the hit series Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba. The popularity of Tanjiro has risen since the anime dropped. He really wasn't on anyone's radar beforehand, but now it's like you cannot scroll past without seeing a request for Tanjiro. Tanjiro will fit in easily with his style in this game. I can see him playing similar to Kenshin with a splash of Dai. Tanjiro is the number 2 spot. Before we top it off at number 1, our honorable mentions. Gintoki from Gintama. He was requested by diehard fans, and every now and then his name pops up in the comment section. Gintoki deserves the slot out of these 5 characters because not only is Gintama a hit manga and anime series for the Weekly Shonen Jump, he is one of the most popular characters in the magazine's history. Second honorable mention goes to Madaka from Madaka Box. Madaka is a fan favorite, but not as strong with newer fans, which the game is targeted for. Madaka being a female representation could help boost the sales and some J-Star fans to buy in. Finally, at number 1, Giorno Giovanna. You all knew this was coming, don't front. Giorno's popularity has risen strictly off the anime. Golden Wind is officially 20 years old, and now Giorno's name has taken over all the comment sections, whether it's on Twitter, whether it's on Facebook, whether it's on YouTube. JoJo's need another representation. Although I believe Jean-Pierre would make the most sense, Giorno would sell better than any character right now. I think Bandai Namco needs to pull the trigger and add Giorno to the roster. And that wraps this video up. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to drop a like and share this to a friend. As always, I'm Enigma. Signing off. Peace, guys. Yeah.